You know what? Screw it. We made this exact same video yesterday talking about Eric Staal, a Buffalo Sabres guy, and whether or not the Canadiens would benefit from making a trade for this player, as suggested by Jean-Charles Lajoie on an article on TVA Sports the other day. But because I know there are going to be people in the comments asking about this other guy, I was like, you know what? We've spoken about this a ton in my stream chat and on Twitter. I'm seeing so many people talking about it, so why not at least join the discussion as well, because that's kind of what this channel even exists for, to be fair. Let's talk about Jack Eichel. Now, I will say, starting this off right off the bat, if you're wondering about my thoughts on yesterday's Habs-Senators game, where the Habs lost again to Ottawa in overtime, well, not overtime, this time it was a shootout, and if you're talking about the goal at the end that should have counted, didn't count, Brendan Gallagher, goalie interference, I didn't watch the game live, so that's my bad, because there's a regional blackout here in Vancouver, so whoop-de-doo, I wasn't able to watch my second favorite team in action. But I did see the replays, was kind of whack. I wasn't there in the moment, so I wasn't really as emotionally invested, I guess, into what happened. I'm just really interested in seeing where things go from here with the Canadiens. Firstly, for Brendan Gallagher, because the guy's probably going to get fined for criticizing the refereeing that is so good in this league, right? And, of course, you know, the situation in Montreal as a whole, because they've been losing games now, and if you're in a position now where people are talking about Jack Eichel, yeah, you know you're in that kind of territory with this team, so on to today's actual topic. Sorry about that little tangent, by the way. I just kind of wanted to get that out there because I know some people will definitely harp on me for my opinions on that. Right now, the Buffalo Sabres, the team that currently houses Jack Eichel, one of the top young stars in the entire NHL, they are tied for last in the East with 14 points in 16 games played. The Devils have 14 points in 14 games, so they are indeed in a higher standing points percentage-wise. But with the Buffalo Sabres and the way they've been trending downwards, we've been seeing guys like Elliot Friedman, for example, talk about how he would not be surprised if an Eichel trade was to coagulate in the next few months, depending on the Sabres and their performance. And so, because Montreal is Montreal and it's the center of the French-speaking hockey world, we've had Canadiens fans coming out here asking the question on whether or not the Canadiens should go after Jack Eichel. And of course, this is just rooted in fantasy. I don't think it's ever going to happen, personally speaking. If it does happen, then I'll bite my tongue and I'll note that I was wrong in this video made on February 24th, Wednesday in 2021. But with this Eichel stuff comes a lot of hypothetical questions that you have to ask. Because, firstly, the big one is return. If you get a guy like Jack Eichel, then you have to have a package that the Buffalo Sabres would absolutely unequivocally say yes to. This is a guy you overpay for. We've spoken about this in several Eichel videos already, but it's gonna cost you one of your best players, if not your best player on the roster already, a top prospect, and significant draft picks as well. You can't just throw around, okay, here's Paul Byron, Jordan Harris, and a first. Say yes to Jack Eichel. No, it's not gonna go down like that. You need to overpay for this kind of guy. Which is why, for example, we had Grant McKegg, a guy who posts a lot of stuff about prospects. He's an NHL scout from 2008 to 2010, and he's got a primarily, let's just say, Montreal-centered fan base. He posted this the other day that got people talking. If you're Marc Bergevin, do you consider offering Nick Suzuki, a defensive prospect, and a second-round pick for Jack Eichel? So, defensive prospect, let's say Matthias Norlander, or Jaden Struble, or Jordan Harris, or I don't know who else is in the system. Romanov, I guess? He's not really a prospect anymore, but you get what I'm saying here. Do you offer Nick Suzuki, Matthias Norlander, and a second for Jack Eichel? 4,000 people voted on this, and 37% said no. I personally voted yes, because if it's Suzuki, Norlander, and a second for Eichel, if Buffalo says yes to that, I think that's a very good Montreal win. Like, Jack Eichel is gonna be a Hall of Fame player. Sure, he's having a bad year this year, but everyone in Buffalo's having a bad year this year. But I just wanted to take a look at this right here, because if we do the math, 37.3% of 4142 is about 1,540-ish people who, on this poll, voted no. They would not trade Suzuki, a second, and a defensive prospect for Jack Eichel. That's not even, like, trade. It's just, would you consider it? People wouldn't even consider that. And I get that Nick Suzuki is so good, but if you're gonna go out there and ask for a Jack Eichel, it starts with Suzuki. It starts with Suzuki. If not, you're adding Kotkaniemi in there, and you're adding Cole Caulfield, another top defensive prospect, a first, and other stuff if it does not involve Suzuki and or Kotkaniemi. And at that point, I don't even think the Buffalo Sabres pick up the phone if you're not even considering a Suzuki or a Kotkaniemi in this kind of move. What, do you think just because it's a big contract in play, you're going to have to take on Shea Weber? No, they're not going to do that. Would you say yes to anything remotely involving that? Absolutely not. Jack Eichel is one of the most valuable young pieces in this NHL today, so the Buffalo Sabres have all the bargaining power when it comes to any trade proposal that any team is going to come out here and give. They have the right to say, well, we're giving you Jack Eichel, so we're not going to settle for Kotkaniemi, Caulfield, and a second. Give us Suzuki, Caulfield, and a first. And it's nuts because that's the kind of conversation that the Sabres could legitimately have. And that's just speaking about return. Our second point we want to talk about here today is the contract. Because Jack Eichel, like it or not, even though he is a very good NHL player, he's going to be very great heading into the long-term future, he's still making a boatload of money. Take a look at that contract he has signed to until 2026 at $10 million AAV. He doesn't have an NMC until 2022-2023, which is why he's even available to being traded at the moment. But the Montreal Canadiens, if you go over to their cap-friendly page, they don't have a lot of cap space anymore because they splurged it all this offseason. They have $280,000 in available cap space, and next year they have $15 million to re-sign guys like Kotkaniemi, re-sign Thomas Tatar and Philippe Deneau and Armia and Arturi Lehkonen. And I get that a lot of these guys aren't going to come back. It's kind of the nature of being a Habs fan, seeing the downward decline of players that are playing in your top line, but it still is a conversation you need to have. You still have Shea Weber making 7.8. Petrie's now making 6.25. Gallagher's out here making 6.5. Not to mention Carey Price making 10.5. Jake Allen, downgrade to 2.8, but he's still there. So there is a cap crunch you have to do because Jack Eichel's going to cost $10 million until 2026. And unless you're moving out significant money like a Paul Byron or somebody else making a lot of money like, I don't know, Jonathan Drouin making 5.5, it's really, really tough to have this kind of conversation. And if you're able to convince a Buffalo team, oh, Jack Eichel trade, here's Jonathan Drouin, take this guy and, I don't know, Caulfield and Yolonen and a second round pick or whatever. Like, I don't know if there is enough firepower there with the Canadiens to try to go out there and convince Buffalo to say yes if you're not trying to include the value contracts. Right now, a value contract is like Nick Suzuki. Nick Suzuki at the moment making $863,000. That is not even a million yet. He has not had his payday. But when you're in this position where the Canadiens want to win, Bergevin's built this team that needs to win because on paper, I thought they would be the best in the North Division and a lot of people thought that they would be the best too, but they're not showing that off because they're playing with a lot less cohesion they have than before at the beginning of the season. Yeah, things get kind of rough, don't they? But regardless, that is indeed a few aspects of the conversation you need to have. First off, it's the return. Secondly, it's actually the contracts and how that work. And, you know, the two conversations, those two right there, those already get Habs fans into a big scruffle when it comes to talking about Jack Eichel, because obviously no team wants to lose a trade. No team wants to overpay for an asset. But at the end of the day, man, it's Jack Eichel we're talking about here. This guy, if he just played on a better team, I honestly think he could be at that same tier. Matthews, McDavid, okay, maybe not McDavid, but like McKinnon. You know, I think he's in that category. It's just surround him with a better team. A team that isn't last in the league. A team that doesn't have a $9 million contract and Jeff Skinner getting scratched night in and night out. You know? There are better teams out there that Eichel would probably excel on, and Montreal would seem like one of them, but it's going to cost you a price, like a very big price. And I'm not talking about Carey Price, but you know what? There is indeed a good enough package, I think, that the Canadians would have. It's just whether or not you would be willing to pay that, Marc Bergevin would be willing to pay that, that's a different story entirely. Just this small offer of Suzuki, a defensive prospect, and a second has already gotten Habs fans out here 30-something percent of them saying, no, I wouldn't even think about it. So let me know in the comments what you think about this whole idea here. What would be the most that you would give up for Jack Eichel? Remember, it's Jack Eichel. This guy is valuable as heck, and you have to overpay for this guy. So as a Habs fan, what would be the most you would be willing to give up? And would you actually want to go after this player? Let's say he does become available and Elliot Friedman's philosophy on what's going on in Buffalo does come true. Do you go after this guy, and what's the biggest price you give out there? Talk to me in the comments what you think. I'll be enjoying this episode of Schwarzenegger 99. And bye.